former Vice President Dick Cheney is recovering today after heart surgery. Cheney said he had been experiencing increasing congestive heart failure. Now, take a look at this. This is the type of device doctors implanted into Cheney to keep his heart functioning. It was once used to keep patients alive as they waited for a heart transplant. But now it's being used on other heart patients.
It is being done right here in Pittsburgh. In fact, this procedure is. Channel 4 Action News anchor Sally Wiggin is here. This sort of stuff is always so remarkable to talk about.
Yeah, and the technology oftentimes is developed in part here,
right?
At the University of Pittsburgh. And life-saving, because these devices are now being used in patients like the former vice president who have severe congestive heart failure, but they're not candidates for transplants. At UPMC's Artificial Heart Institute, they call it a destination device. And the destination is life. Bob Baum of Latrobe has a lot more in common with Dick Cheney than just age. They are both 69. They now share the experience of having one of these in their chests.
It's an LVAD in the short form, and what it does is take blood from the left ventricle, the main pumping chamber of the heart, and it then pumps that blood into the aorta, which is the main artery coming off the heart that then distributes blood through the body.
It is used to help a heart that is too weak to support normal body function.
It's terrible. Can't breathe.
Bob is a diabetic with kidney problems, so was not eligible for a transplant. Without something, he had about a year to live. Now he's wearing part of his heart outside his body.
I mean, it's right here. The only thing you have to do is, when the battery's got low, you check your battery. Press this button. You check it. If it's low, change the battery. Just pull them out.
The last decade was called the decade of drugs because of the marked advancement in drug technology and drugs that are available to treat this illness. And this decade has been termed the decade of devices.
And the near future is even brighter, with smaller devices like this fitting right into the heart sac in the body, giving patients continued hope.
I can do more with my grandkids. I couldn't do anything with them before. You know, I play baseball with them.
That is special. Continued research is crucial because the incidence of congestive heart failure is increasing. 500,000 new cases a year. As the population ages and as more people survive the heart attacks and strokes that can weaken their hearts. Sally Wiggin, Channel 4 Action News.